Hello, good afternoon. Ano bang boses ko? Okay, so klarong boses ko, sino magsabi niyan? Kay baka mag-start na ako. So
okay, ma'am. Okay na po, ma'am.
Ayan, ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
Okay, thank you for that. Okay, so we'll start with our first module for the computer hardware. So since the final exam will be on the second week of June, so I'm going to give you, I guess, instead of 3 modules pa ang kulang, so magbibigay na lang ako ng, titingnan ko muna yung module 5, kung konti lang yung topic, so isasama ko yung module 6. Pero pag mahaba po yung topic sa module 5, I guess isang module na lang po ang ating kulang, so that you can also focus the other activities and the laboratory activities kailangan ninyong gawin, okay? So, regarding the module 4, kagabi, I already uploaded the activities for the module 4. And so, na-upload na ko na din yung activities ninyo for the laboratory sa Google Docs and Sheets. Yung slides, later on na lang kasi hinahanap ko pa yung topic na ibibigay ko sa inyo. Okay? So, give me until within this week. Okay, so ipapakita ko muna no before I'm going to start with the module 4. Ipapakita ko muna yung nandito sa ating classwork. Wait lang, no? Nag-loading kasi siya. Okay, so punta muna ako sa Bravo Walk 2. Okay, so I already posted the laboratory for docs and sheets and also the elaborate activities for the hardware and system technology basics. So sa laboratory no, paspasan ko lang din i-discuss yung ating computer hardware module number 4 no, kasi kailangan nating i-cover up ang ating klase because there was a time na full Wednesday tayo hindi nakapag-meet because of the no signal. So passing ko din muna to ah. So that you have an idea on how to answer. For the laboratory number 2, last time diniscuss ko, wherein you're going to share the link. Ngayon, I'm thinking na, instead of sharing the link to me, ako na gagawa ng format, and then you just click the turn in. Okay? If after clicking, so ito yung activities nyo, no? Laboratory number 2. So you have the activity 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So you have 5 activities, each worth of 20 points. So, a total of 100 points ito. Okay? So, how will I grade you? There is a procedure for you to, it's a guide for you to do the activities. So, for example, here you just type your name, you're in section, and the activity number 1, wag na po i-edit. Ang edit po natin is the date and year, kung kanino natin isi-send ang ating personal letter. Okay, so yung content, i-edit po yan, change po natin yan. What will be the content? The content will be your letter personally na isi-send mo. For example, po your mom, or your father, or brother, sisters, or your girlfriends, or boyfriends, ganyan. So your loving, anong yung relationship mo, kung kanino mo pinapadala. Okay, so your name, say edit yan. Okay, take note ha, make the content of your letter justified, and your name should be bold and capitalized. Yun ang, ito yung aking criteria na i-check. Okay? That is for the activity number 1. For the number 2, stay pa rin. Do your, put your name, your section. So, newsletter, bayaan lang yan dyan. Ito lang po tatanggalin at copy the procedure. Wherein, the title should be in Oswald style. Size 24. Naka-bold siya, color blue, and center align. So your topic, the topic will be about yourself. So you state lang kung about ayun, kailan ka pinanganak, sino-sino yung parents mo, kapatid mo, mga ganyan, ilang taon ka na, where you study, mga everything about yourself, your likes and dislikes or favorites, mga ganyan. Okay. So ito yung example no ng aking ginawa. Wherein newsletter, the title, which is the name, the full name, si Charles Babbage. So itong kanito are the discussions, I mean, anything about Charles Babbage. Kailan siya pinanganak, anong course ang graduate, what course graduated, mga ganyan. And then, sino-sino yung tatay niya, anong known siya to be the father of the computers, mga ganyan. And then, don't forget to put your pictures. Yung pictures ha, hindi yung walang damit, okay? Yung pictures na may damit, okay? Doesn't mean na kailangan naka-formal po kayo dyan. Basta, may damit lang po, okay? So, there will be three columns, ha? So, how will I know if it's in three column? Ito ay isang three column. 1, 2, 3. I already discussed that word to make it in three columns, okay? Next, for activity number 3. So, type pa rin ang name, your sections, greeting card, wag galawin yan, ito lang tatanggalin. So, example of the greeting card is this one. You just look for the Google, ano yung mga pictures, and then you can customize the content of the greetings card, okay? And then, after you create it, you do your activity, kasi hanggang... bakit to? Sorry, no? Dapat wala na to, ha? Just, disregard this one. Hanggang exercise number 3 lang itong dito. Docs activity 1, 2, 3. And then, after you do that, kung natapos na, pwede naman hindi nyo kailangan tapusin yan because the deadline will be until May 23. Pwede, i-X nyo lang yung browser, then go back afterwards. Pero pag natapos na, ang gagawin nyo is hindi po share. Yung meron dito sa site, which is turn in. Hindi ko may pakita sa inyo yung turn in button because I'm the one who created the activity. So wala po akong turn in. So sa inyo, lalabas yung turn in dyan. So ang gagawin nyo lang, hanapin si turn in dito sa upper right corner wherein you can find it beside the share button, yung turn in button, okay? So, that is for activity number 1 to 3. Ngayon sa 4. Sa 4, just open it. And then, edit your name here. So, edit your name. You put your pictures beside your name. And do the editing. Yung tinuro ko last time, no? Edit nyo lang yan. After you do it, then click the share button here sa taas. Same with the activity number 5, which is the application letter. Okay, sa application letter, that the edit portion is this one. Yan. Ito naman, dito lang sa X. Lagay nyo kung ano yan. 2025, pwede din 2028. Yan, kayo na po ang mag-adjust. So, assuming lang po ito for your application letter. Okay? Ang hindi i-edit ay ito, this one. Huwag nyo po i-edit ito. And so with this one, ang i-edit nyo po ito dito. So what will be the content? So sinabi ko na dito, may guide po kayo. The first paragraph, you must state the purpose of your letter, the position of type of work for which you are applying for. For example, I am blah, 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 I'm applying for the position of chief engineer in your company. Mga ganyan. Then second paragraph, you state why are you applying? So, ano ang purpose na pag-apply ninyo? So, sabi nyo, I want to apply in this position because I am a licensed engineer, mga ganyan, a graduate of BSMRE degree courses of the Zamboanga City, Zamboanga Peninsula Polytechnic State University and so on and so forth. Okay, sa closing program, you state, i-answer nyo lang. I'm willing for the interview at your convenience. you may contact me in my email address, or you may contact me through my cell phone number 09 blah blah blah. So mga ganyan, no? So, and then dito, write a brief this expression of your appreciation. Ano sasabihin natin dyan? Sabihin nyo, hoping to be part of your prestigious company. Mga ganyan. Okay? And then sincerely, your signature. Ma'am, paano ko ilalagay yung signature? So, gawin nyo yung signature, picturean, and then insert image. Diba? Ganun lang din yung gagawin natin. Okay, meron po akong note. Make the content of your letter justified. So, ibig sabihin, itong content, naka-justify. Your name should be bold and capitalized. So, we all know, capitalized means naka-caps lock po lahat. Capital letters po lahat. Okay? And then go to this one. Meron po dito, turn in. Click turn in. Okay? So, we're done with the laboratory number 2 of your Google Docs. So, ganun lang. Limang activities lang. It will just give you an idea on how to use the Google Docs. Now, meron pa po tayong Google Sheets. Okay? Wait lang sandali, ah. Okay, so wait lang, no? Okay, man.
Reportado.
Ha?
Reportado. Metaman work from home.
Reporta? Ano yung Aminanda? Yay! Okay. Wait lang, ha? Ano yun? Okay. Ay, wait. Saan naman yun? Oh, yan. Okay, so this is for the Google Sheets also. So we have only 2 activities for Google Sheets. So each worth of 50 points. A total of 100 points. Bakit 50? Bakit? Because you're doing the formula here. That's why 50 points po siya. Okay, so anong i-edit natin? Here, name. Here in section. Pita, ilalaki ko para mas klaro-klaro. Ayan. Activity number 1. So, we have here pera must be 1,000. So, nandito po yun, no? Pera is 1,000 pesos each. So, itatype mo lang yung 10,000, no? So, I already discussed this one. And then, you can make it additional of 0 para maging 1,000. Tapos, itatype mo lahat yung 1,000. Pero, meron naman yung tinuruan ko, di ba, last time, the easiest one, wherein you don't need to type it all. You just click the, pag yung arrow mo naging ganyan, then click this one, arrow na ganyan, naging click this one. Pag naging cross na, you just drag it, papunta sa last name, and then release. Oh, yan ay tinuro ko na last time. And then, salary loan, si bookkeeper 67. Life and retirement equals, mag-start kayo sa equals yung formula natin. So, equal sign, basic salary. Basic salary is not a word, but you click the basic salary of a certain person and then multiply it to 8.5%. Okay? So, ngayon, meron tayong note. Make the title such as the name of employee, position, etc. So, ibig sabihin nito, anong gagawin natin dito? Yan daw ay naka-bold, center, font size 14, color is blue, and style is Georgia. Okay? Make the name of the employees. Bawiga, Andrew, yan. Ito mga employees. I-highlight nyo lang. Ano yung sinabi? Make its font size 14, color is red, style is Comic Sans MS. Okay? So, ganun lang. So, ang gagawin ninyo, so, lahat ito ay magkakaroon ng value sa loob ng kanilang cells using this formula. So, makikita ko yan kung nagawa ninyo successfully, correctly yung pinapagawa ko. And then, turn in lang ulit. Ang turn in, nandito lang po sa site ng share. Okay? So, with the Google Sheets number 2, the same pa rin. Name your section. Okay. So, ganun pa rin. Yung formula nandyan, no? Use the formula below. Yan. Yan po yung formula natin. And then, the title of the school and its address center. And change the font style you want. So, kayo na po ang bahala anong font style na gusto nyo and anong kulay. Okay, for example, paano gawing center? Pag ito ay ginawa nyo lang center, lalabas lang po siya center sa isang cell. Yan. Pero, pag sinabing center, ito yon. Kasi hanggang dito po yung ating papel, no? Hanggang dito yung sa ating lulo ng ating table. So, click nyo muna yung merge. And then, click the center. Yan. So, same with this one. Yan po, yan din po ang gagawin ninyo dito sa baba. Okay? So, ganun lang po yung pagkagawa niyan. Okay? So, we're done with the sheets and the docs activity. Ngayon, may activity din dito. This is for the module 4. Just click it. Ayan, no? You type your name. And then ito. Ito yung sinasabi ko. You just explain in your own words the flow of the 4 basic computer functions. So, meron tayong input, the process, the storage, and the output. So, you can do a certain examples on how it is input, the process, and storage or output. So, for example, may answer na po. Ngayon, ito no, 2 points po for the correct if software ba siya or hardware and specify what the picture is used for 3 points. For example, is this a software or hardware? Just click the option. Tampo gusto ko hardware. So later on, malaman natin kung ano yung mga software and hardware. Okay? What is this and what is this used for? So ano ito? This is a USB. Anong gamit ni USB? So kayo na po ang bahala magsabi dyan. Okay, after you do it all, answering, then click submit. Okay? So, ganun lang po yung activities natin for that, topic. Okay? Now, we go to the topic, the main part, the topic. So, dadalian ko yan, no? Hanggang 2:30 tayo. I will try to discuss all of it. Okay, kasi kailangan kong maximize ang ating time because of the brownouts and all, walang signal. Tapos malapit na po yung ating final exams. Okay, so module 4, we have a hardware and systems technology basic. Since I will discuss all of the topic under module 4, so expect your quiz number 4 regarding this one. So basahin ninyo ito. I already uploaded this in your Google Stream, the lecture. So, basahin ninyo, okay? So, the quiz for this one, same pa rin, no? It can be fill in the blanks or multiple choice. And then, ano pa ba? Expect it on Sunday. Pero pag wala pa rin sa Sunday, so expect it by next week, okay? So, what is the course outcome? We can able to evaluate computer network use on board ships in terms of modularity and expandability. The course learning outcome, identify the use of input devices, output devices, processing device, storage devices, and other hardware devices, especially found within the motherboard. So yan, input and output devices. So we have this, no, watch this video clip. Diniscuss ko na to, binigay ko na to sa inyo. Okay, so This is the computer system. So, inawag siya computer system because it consists of an input, a process, a storage, and the output. Below is a sample of how the input, process, storage, and output goes along together, no? Yan. Tapos, meron po tayong three main components sa computer. It can be hardware, software, and IT professionals or peopleware. So, this is the physical part, the hardware. Software is this one. Bakit software? Kasi makikita lang po ang laman nito sa loob ng computer. For example, anong nakikita natin sa loob ng ating mga cellphones ay yun po yung software. Yung cellphone na hawak-hawak natin, yung physical part, ay yun po yung hardware. Okay. So the peopleware are those gumagamit ng mga computers at saka nag-create ng mga computers. That is why peopleware is the most important component of a computer system. Siyempre, pag wala yung peopleware, wala po mag-exist si computer hardware or computer software. Kasi sila po ang gumagawa, nag-design ng mga hardware and software. Okay? So, hardware, physical equipment, and machinery associated with the computer system. Ayan. Hardware is a collection of all the parts you can physically touch. Software is a set of instructions for a computer to perform specific operations. Yan na. So, there are two types of computers. Meron tayong desktop and laptop. Anong difference silang dalawa? Obviously, lahat ng ito ay nandito sa isang unit. Unlike this one, kailangan mo pa ng cord to connect to the CPU, to the mouse, and to the computer. I mean, keyboard. Okay? So, we have types of peripheral devices. Anong sinasabi sa peripheral? It is a device that is connected to a computer but is not part of the core of computers. Ano-ano yung mga device na hindi kasama pag bumibili tayo ng computer? So, yun po yung computer peripheral. Like, for example, bibili tayo ng computer pero walang printer. So, printer is a computer peripheral. Okay? So, the three categories of the peripheral, hindi kasama si storage device, no? Only input, output, and storage. I mean, hindi kasama si processing device pala. Si input, output, and storage devices lang po ang nandyan sa category ni computer peripheral. Okay. So now we go to the input device. Ayan. So from the term input, it means that you need to have a device to enter the data to the inside the computer. Kaya input. So meron tayong two categories. It can be a keyboard or the source data. So si keyboard, nag-iisa lang talaga siya. And that is the computer keyboard. Ano yung computer keyboard? The most fundamental and widely used input device. It is considered as the principal support of most computer-based applications for the entry of alphanumeric information and other functions. So, ano yung computer keyboard? The most fundamental and widely used input device. So, hindi po si mouse ang most fundamental input device, kundi si keyboard. Take note of that. So, meron tayong iba't ibang klaseng keyboard. Ito ay isang projection keyboard kasi meron lang siyang projector to project ang keyboard. Ito ay isang laptop keyboard. This is connected to your laptop. This one is a virtual keyboard. The keyboard that is known to be in your na makikita sa ating cellphones or tablet is your virtual keyboard. Mechanical keyboard, ayan. Pag meron, yung keyboard merong bakante sa gitna, yan po ay isang membrane keyboard. This one is a multimedia or internet keyboard because meron siyang button to click or connect diretso sa multimedia and the internet. Ito ay wireless, obviously kasi wala siyang wire. Only this one i-connect mo sa computer at magagamit mo na tong keyboard na ito. The gaming keyboard, yan. Ito yung tsura ng gaming, no? May mga colors dyan. They are the lighted keys daw for playing in the night. This one is ergonomic keyboard. Tinan nyo, no? Pa-iba yung kanyang design. And this one is a flexible keyboard. From the term flexible, pwede lang natin siyang i-fold and i-roll. Okay? So those are the different types of keyboard. Now we have the source data entry device. Sa source data entry device, we have the pointing devices and the scanning device. So yun lang po yun. Wait lang ha. So, si pointing device, obviously, pag-pointing, we're talking about mouse. So, si mouse ay may left-click button, right-click button, and scrolling wheel. Ayan. So, there are also different types of mouse, especially yung ating keyboard may different types, no? Meron po different types din ng mouse. So what are the different types of mouse? Ito ay mechanical mouse. Itong sa baba niya, ito ay isang trackball, yung bola. And this is the most traditional mouse in the history of the computers. So ito naman ay isang optical mouse. Ito yung mostly na ginagamit na natin ngayon. Yung light niya nandito sa baba. Ito ay laser mouse. Transparent po yung kanyang baba. Ito ay for gaming mouse because meron yan siya mga buttons dito na suitable for gamings. Ito naman ay isang trackball mouse. Nandito po sa taas yung ating ball. And this is malalaki po yung kanyang left click and right click. Stylus mouse because it looks like a stylus pen. Presentation mouse because may mga pwede po tayong mag-click dito for presentations. Vertical mouse because naka-vertical po yung ating left and right click. We have also joystick. Ito yung joystick. Mostly, ginagamit ito for gaming. Ito naman touchscreens, no? Alam naman natin yung tsura ng touchscreens. Especially sa ating cellphone, ay mga touchscreens na. Digitizing tablet. So, ito na yung uso ngayon. Ginagamit ng mga teachers for them to be able to use to explain in their online class, parang meron silang blackboard. Mostly makikita din natin to, no? Mostly makikita din natin ito when you're getting your ID, meron doon signature. Ito yung ginagamit natin. Also, we have the touchpad. So si touchpad po ay makikita natin sa ating laptop. Yan. We're done with the pointing device. Now we go to the scanning devices. So scanning, ano-ano yan? So makikita natin sa mga supermarkets and mga malls. Yung isa na yun, si barcode reader. Yan. Ito, sa bangko, scan niya yung cheque. Ito naman, when you're during elections, nakikita natin yan. In-input ka agad yung mga sinelect nating candidates. pwede din the best example. Best example is the Lotto outlets, no? Yung Lotto, nagtataya tayo ng Lotto, so automatic shade change lang natin. So yung ginawa nating shades, ipapasok niya sa computer para ibigay sa iyo ang receipts. Ito naman ay OCR wherein yung mga nakikita natin text dito, in-scan niya para ilagay automatic sa computer. This one is a fax machine, combination of a printer and a telephone line. Pero mostly hindi na tao na bebenta ngayon because we can already send a message or a letter through email. Kasi ngayon online na tayo. So, available na po si si email. So, we have also the imaging system. If you want to put a certain picture na na-print out or gusto mong mga text or documents na gusto nilang ilagay sa picture, kailangan mo si imaging system. Ito naman, the card readers. So, the ATM, no? Dito na yung mga card. Napasok natin yung ating mga credit cards. I mean, card natin. Like this one, for example, nandun kayo sa mall. If you want to pay your credit cards, pwede din swipe lang nila. Or sa KCC Mall, hinahanap nila yung KCC card. Sa SM naman, hinahanap nila yung SM Advantage card para may points po kayo. Parang loyalty points po yun. And this one, these are the card reader, the different card readers. So you can put your memory cards here automatic. Makikita natin sa computer na yan. And so with this SIM card, pwede din po tayong maglagay ng SIM card sa smart card reader. Okay? So those are the cards. So ngayon, ano to si voice recognition input device? So si voice recognition input devices, so you're inputting your voice with recognition. So ibig sabihin, aside from the inputting, meron po siyang minamatch pa niya po yung patterns ng inyong boses. For example, if your house is locked with a voice recognition input devices, so anong kailangan natin? So you need the password and yung boses. So if ever yung mga kasama natin na hindi niya bahay, alam niyo yung password. For example, a password ay open. Pero yung boses niya, hindi naman parehas nagmamatch sa ating boses. So hindi pa rin mag-o-open yun. Because it was locked by a voice recognition input device. So ano, yan po yung purpose niyan. The audio input devices naman, ito yung mga kailangan natin para ma-input po natin yung audio. Like our headset. Kasi ang headset is a combination of a headphone, yung para pwede natin marinig, and a microphone. So yung microphone is the one that will input our audio, our voice, inside the computer. So we have also the digital cameras and the sensor. Yung sensor, alam natin yung sensor, no? Yung sensor, makikita natin sa mga mall wherein meron silang post doon na paglalabas o papasok tayo and detect kung meron tayong kinuhang bagay na hindi pa nabayaran. Okay? So those are the inputs. So ang dami naming input devices, no? So we're done with the input now. Now we go to the output device. Ayan. So time check is already 2:13. Okay. So output. So yung output, mayroong soft copy and hard copy. So what is soft copy? A soft copy refers to an output that appears on screen or in audio or voice form. Ang hard copy, it refers to the printed output in paper, film, or in other tangible format. So, yan. Soft copy muna tayo. So, soft copy will be the display screen. So, diyan po natin kailangan makita yung mga things. Kaya nga soft copy kasi wala tayong dala-dalang tangible part. So, there are different types of monitor. Sorry. So we have the cathode ray tube. So yung TV natin is also what we call at monitor. Dati yung TV natin, di ba, bulky. So katulad na ng monitor, bulky siya. Ang tawag dyan is CRT or the cathode ray tube. Ito naman ay LCD. This is the liquid crystal display. Kayo na magbabasa yung mga definitions, ha? So, passing na ako. PFT monitors. This is the LED or light emitting diode monitor. The DLP monitor or the digital light processing monitors. The touch screen. The plasma screen monitors. Yan. The OLED or organic light emitting diode monitor. So there are, those are the different types of monitors. Ngayon, parang gumagamit na ata tayo mga LED, LCD or OLED. So depende, no. Medyo ang OLED ata is mas mahal kasi sinabi naman dito, it can offer images in 360 or 3D vision. So mas malaki yung kanyang capacity or features, so mas mahal itong OLED. So we have also an audio output device. So yung audio output devices, so these are the devices that produce on output in the form of voice and other recognizable sounds audible to human ears. Yan, no? These are usually heard over the telephone, especially equipment and other machines that give instructions and informations. So yan. So ano yung mga audio output? Yung mga output na para marinig natin yung voice or audio. So we have here the speakers and the headphones. So yung headphones, sound lang yung nakikita natin. Pero pag microphone, mayroon siyang microphone, ang tawag na dyan is headsets. It include both headphones and a microphone. Meron ding headsets na parang ganito lang siya, parang earbuds. 'Di ba? Yung which fits inside the ear. So yung earbuds ang tawag dyan. Fit inside the ear. Ngayon, yung hard copy naman, so, kailangan natin si printer pati si platter. So, yung printer ay naga-print lang siya for the bond papers. So, merong dalawang types. Impact and non-impact printers. So, si impact, meron tayong dot matrix printers and line printers. So, mas mabagal ito kaysa sa non-impact kasi mas mabilis to because they use laser, inkjet, thermal, photo, platters, etc. Ang problema lang sa non-impact is that medyo in a due time, nawawala yung mga text sa isang papel. Katulad yung mga receipts sa mall or receipts sa ating ATM machines wherein nawawala ang kanyang text in the long run. Kasi non-impact kasi yung ginagamit nilang printer. So this is the dot matrix. Line printers, mostly ito yung ginagamit sa pag-print ng mga board exams, etc. Okay, no? Non-impact, laser, inkjet, ito na yun for the thermal printers. Photo printers, and this is a multifunction printers. Sikat na talaga si multifunction printers kasi it is called a multifunctions because it can do scanning, photocopying, printing. So, mas marami siyang ginagawa. So, mas affordable to kaysa sa pagbibili mo ng isa-isa. Bibili ka pa ng scanner, bibili ka pa ng photocopier, bibili ka pa ng printer. So, pwede mo na tong bilhin yung tatlo. I mean, yung tatlo sa isang printer. Ito naman si platters, is a kind of printers, pero malaki yung kanyang papel. So, it is used for creating maps, charts, graphs, architectural drawings and other forms of graphics. So meron tayong pen-based platters and electrostatic platter. Yan. Okay, so we're done with the input and output. Ngayon yung elaborate natin, no? Nandun na, in-upload ko na yun. So ito yung gagawin ninyo. Wait lang. So gagawin ninyo yun. Nandun na yun. Okay, so now we go to the module 4, unit 2. Okay, break muna tayo mga 2 minutes more. Mga 1 minute. Wait lang ha. Break muna tayo 1 minute. Okay, so our 1 minute break tapos na, no? Medyo marami-rami po yung ating topic, no? So pasensya lang because I need to cover up for our missing lectures, no? Okay, so unit 2 will be focusing on the central processing device and storage devices. So yan, so sa central processing device, we only have one, which is the central processing unit or the CPU. Ito po yung CPU, no? Ito yung front portion, ito yung back. Marami po siyang mga maliliit na pins. CPU is composed of 5 basic components. We have the control unit, arithmetic logic unit, the main storage, registers, and buses. So the definitions of the control unit, arithmetic logic unit, main storage, registers, and buses, please read it for your additional information. Okay. Sana. Kaya nagbabasa dito, no? Okay, dito ako sa secondary storage. So, secondary storage is also known as the auxiliary storage. Bakit siya tinawag secondary? Because the primary storage can be found under the CPU. So, yung secondary storage is a separate storage outside the computer. So, ang connected lang sa kanya is a cable. Okay? So, these are the data hierarchy the measurements for storage. So ngayon, ang pinakamataas ngayon is terabyte. Pero the hard drive, di ba, is only 2 terabytes pa lang. I don't know if meron na ba tayong 4 terabytes. Okay, so we have different storage. We can have magnetic tape. Ito yung pinakauna, no? Cassette tape, the VHS tape. So they are all under magnetic tape. We also have magnetic disc. These are our hard disk. Nagamit pa natin to. And this is the floppy disk. So ito ay medyo hindi nyo nakikita. Because dati, ang sinisave naming files are to this one. Ngayon, meron na po tayong USB. At yun na po yung ginagamit natin. Okay, for your other additional information, kailan natin gamitin si C at si K in telling the disk. Okay? So the last one is the optical disk. Ayan, meron tayong CD-ROM, yung mga CD, DVD, and so on. So we have also, so you were done with the storage. Now we go to the computer case. So ang tawag sa computer case is cases or tower. Ito na yon. This is the computer case. Okay, this is the front side, the back side, and the left side or left side ata to. Okay. So makikita natin yung mga different buttons na meron dyan and its purpose. Yan. Ngayon, sa loob dito ng CPU, ay makikita po natin itong green. Ang green na ito hanggang dito po yan. Yan dyan, no? So this is what we call our motherboard. Kaya nga mother. Motherboard. Okay, so we'll continue, no? Sorry for that. I have only 1 minute more, no? So can we extend and give me until 10 minutes more pa? Tapusin ko lang talaga to. Okay. So we have the motherboard, no? So si motherboard ay siya yung basis ng ating computer. Kasi doon naka-insert, naka-connect ang lahat ng mga different peripherals of a computer. So ito po yung itsura ni motherboard. So ito po yung ating North Bridge and the South Bridge. How will we know if that where is the North Bridge? So si North Bridge po yung ating basis. Kung nakikita po natin si CPU socket dito, yung saan i-coconnect yung CPU. So yung side niya, which is the square, will be your North Bridge. And then yung sa side niya, na square din, will be your South Bridge. Ganun lang po yun. Okay? So si North Bridge is connected directly to the CPU. Yan. So ang tawag sa kanya is Memory Controller Hub or the Graphics and Memory Controller Hub. While the South Bridge, so slower capabilities of the motherboard lang siya. And ang tawag sa kanya is Input Output or IO Controller Hub. Okay? Yan. Kaya na magbabasa nito, no? So ito yung mga itsura ni CPU. I mean ni motherboard. Ito yung nilalagay nyo dito yung CPU. So kaya yung tawag dito ay CPU socket. So automatic, nandito si North Bridge. And this one will be your South Bridge. Ganun lang po. So we also have other computer peripherals. Ito yung mga kailangan natin pangbilhin para for the computer safety. So unlike yung ating laptop, meron na po siyang built-in na parang pwede nyo siya, kahit brownout, pwede natin gamitin. Pero yung CPU, yung desktop, pag brownout, yun yung talaga pwedeng gamitin. Tapos, mag-automatic off siya. Ganon. So kailangan po natin si UPS or Uninterruptible Power Supply because it will give us 5 to 30 minutes to save our files. Yan. Kailangan natin save yung ating files and to turn off our computer properly para hindi po masira ang ating computer. And we also need the ABR or Automatic Voltage Regulator. So from the term alone, siya po yung nag-regulate ng ating boltahe. Kasi minsan, tumataas, tapos bumababa yung kuryente. And this will also cause our computer to get damage. So, kailangan natin ng ABR para kahit magtumaas o bumaba yung ating boltahe, and same pa rin yung kanyang boltahe na binibigay kay computer. Okay. So, meron din tayong MATCO processor chips. Ayan. Yung graphic coprocessor chips, these chips are all nakadikit na po ito sa ating mga motherboard. Okay? System clock, ito naman, nandun yan sa motherboard natin, yung SRAM and the DRAM and the ROM chips, yan. At ito naman si bus lines. So si bus lines, lalaki ko no para makita niyo. Ayan, yung mga wires dyan. That is what we call the bus line. So, yan yung mga connections na kuryente, na mga data, informations from the computer to the other peripherals. So, kailangan natin si bus line. Ayan. So, meron ding ports, no? So, yung nakikita natin sa likod ng central ng CPU chassis, the computer chassis. So ito ay for the keyboard and mouse. So ang tawag dito ay PS2 port. Yan, PS2 port po ang bilog. Mostly ngayon ang keyboard pati mouse ay USB na, kaya meron na siyang USB ports. Ito for the internet. These two are for the printer. Yan po yung ginagamit para sa printer natin. Ito naman is for the VGA port. And this one is for the headset, microphones, and speakers. And this one is for the game or MIDI port. Ayan. Ito naman yung mga different ports, no? Pwede nyo pong basahin yan so that you have an idea on what it is. Ito naman si video and sound cards, no? Kasama din yan sa ports. Meron siya dito. Ito yung ginagamit wherein if you want to have a good quality videos in our monitor. Especially when we're playing games, kailangan talaga daw malaki yung inyong video cards. So, ito yung inaan natin para malaro natin ng mabuti ang ating games. Kailangan din natin si LAN because minsan kasi, yung computer kasi is wala pong Wi-Fi katulad ng ating mga cellphones and laptops. So, kailangan mo niyang ganyan so that you can connect to the Wi-Fi and to the different networks ng computer. So, ang tawag dito ay local area network card. And later on, after this one, our next topic will be about local area network. So, doon nyo malalaman kung ano yung sinasabi kong local area network. Okay, so we're done with our topic. Now, I'm going to discuss your laboratory. Since we have no face-to-face and mostly all of you walang computer, laptop sa bahay, so ang ginawa ko na lang is to have a games regarding your knowledge for the hardware. Ayan. Mga tatlong games ata to. We have the exercise number one. Wait lang ah. Okay, for exercise one, no? Matching games. Gutan yun. So, gagawa ko ng Google Forms dito. Nandun yung mga names dito. And then, this one, no? Nandun lang na. Oh, sige, sir. Okay, so, ito. For example, dito, no? So, bonus lang. So, ano to? This is a... So, for example, hanapin ko dito. Gamepads. External headset, joystick, keyboard, laptop, mobile phone, mouse, scanner, screen. Oh, lalagay ko dito screen. So, this is a screen. So, ito type ko, no? Sa Google Forms yan later on. Aha. Yan ang gagawin ninyo. So, for exercise number two, this is for your laboratory, no? Kasi wala man tayong laboratory para face-to-face, para ipakita yung laboratory or... Wala din man kayong mga computers para i-require ko, ipakita nyo yung knowledge nyo. Open your computer, titingnan ko kung explain nyo kung anong tawag dyan, anong tawag dyan. Wala naman, paano yung ipa-determine or identify what are the computer parts, okay? Ito naman, complete the sentence. So, she's going to take pictures with the, o ano, napin ko dito. So, ang malapit is the camera or the cellphone. Kasi cellphone naman, pwede naman natin mag-take ng pictures. So, she's going to take pictures with the camera, tapos pwede din cellphone. Pero, titingnan nyo sa baba, baka meron dun daw gagamitin ng cellphone or the camera. So, before you type, titingnan nyo muna kung magamit yung lahat. And then, ano po itong mga square? Yan po ay ilalagay natin sa loob ng box if this is an input, an output, a storage, a processing, or a computer system. A computer system is a combination of all the four. Siya isang input, output, siya meron, pwede siyang matawag na computer system because it has an input, an output, a storage, and a process. Okay? For example, si mouse. So, ano si mouse? So, I ba o S, P, or CS? Okay? So, for exercise number 3, I guess this is the last, no? Exercise number 3, crossword puzzle po tayo. So, you write the word found inside the box to complete the sentence. So, ano yung box natin? So, wala palang itong box. So, kayo po ang maghahanap ng word na yan. So, ano naman ako ng found inside the box? Okay, so 1 point per each ba? Per each, no? For example, number 15. Ano yan? So, ilalagay nito dito. There are five letters. So, anong tawag dito sa 15? So, kung CPU, tatlo lang yun. So, hanapin nyo kung anong tawag dito. Okay, so crossword puzzle po yan. So, that's all. So, we're done. So, you just wait for the quiz number 4 and for the laboratory activities to be uploaded. Okay? So, any questions? So, time check 2:40. So, tamang-tama talaga extension of 10 minutes. So, question po tayo? May question ba? I guess silence means walang question, ha? No questions regarding the topic, no questions regarding the activities, and so on, ha? Okay, so if no questions and we're done with our module 4, please open your camera for my documentations of this topic. Okay, open po natin ang camera. Ayan. Okay. 1, 2, 3. Smile. Ayan. Another one. 1, 2, 3. Smile. Okay. Guys, thank you for your time, ha? Stay safe and God bless. So, yung ating Google link, I mean, yung ating klase ay naka-upload na yung iba doon sa ating YouTube account. Okay, so thank you guys for your time. Stay safe and God bless. Do your activities. Okay, so second week of June will be your final exam. Okay, the pointers will be given before the final exam. Thank you. Stay safe and God bless. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, ma'am. Stay safe.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, bye-bye.